Freemason, freelancer, free agents, we faster. Big contracts, big contractors, built pyramids, period, we masters. No caterpillars, it was just a lot of niggas, a lot of great thinkers and a lot of great inventors. All white mansion, I'm the child of God. All black diamonds, times were hard. New Rolls Royce, guess you made it, nigga. All white neighborhoods, you they favorite nigga. My top back like JFK. They wanna push my top back like JFK. So I JFK. Join forces with the kings and we ate all day. Right now I can rewrite history. I stopped writing, so fuck it, I'll do it mentally. I go to the grave before I be a bitch, nigga. Better behave, you dealing with some rich niggas. Started in the ghetto, now we worldwide. Multiplying and I pray to God we never die. I go to the grave before I be a bitch, nigga. Better behave, you dealing with some rich niggas. Started in the ghetto, now we worldwide. Multiplying and I pray to God we never die.
Niggas couldn't do nothing with me, they put the devil on me. How the preferred niggas just squeeze the metal on me. Rumors of Lucifer, I don't know who to trust. Whole world want my demise, turn the music up. Hear me clearly, if y'all niggas fear me, just say y'all fear me. Fuck all these fairy tales.
Hey, welcome back, y'all. This is gonna be my exposure video and the explanation of the Masons and the Illuminati. Basically, it's gonna be about the top notch one, the one that started this, and that's JayZ. And I say he started it because I do believe that he's got a lot to do with our perception of at least the rap community and probably all Hollywood altogether. But you'll see what I mean as this video progresses. I'm gonna play a few clips and I'm gonna have some audio clips. So you'll understand a little bit further. I'm not going to make this video as long as the rest of my videos. I'm going to try to keep it down. Less talking and just more clips. But I have to explain the clips. So just bear with me, okay? I just want to go over just a few things that is important for us to know in the woke community. Hollywood is nothing but a sham to hide the deception, but we perceive it to be a glamorous life. I do believe that Jay-Z is one of the gatekeepers. He denies being involved in Illuminati, but he's also denied being a Mason, but that's very clear and blatant that he is. Yet he seems to be all over the internet, and he plays homage to his Luciferian god. He's involved in the NBA, NFL, of course, music, and even politics. I believe that there's a reason why they use Kanye West as well. His name is a prefix of a deity that they worship. And his last name is a reference to the sun god. Is the reason why he calls himself Jesus, okay? And if people don't well aware that Jesus is another word for Osiris, which is the sun god, okay? Could Jay-Z be a mediator for the powers that may be? Powers of another realm? I'm sorry for the meme, y'all, but I just had to throw that in there, okay? I'm going to explain to you how the Illuminati and the Masons are one and the same. I have explained before that they come from the same philosophy of Luciferianism. The difference is the sole purpose, and literally the sole purpose, is that your soul. The Illuminati is the bottom line of the bottom of the pyramid. Okay, literally. The levels of the NWO goes extremely deep. I'm only going to talk about the Illuminati, though, just in the simplest way. And some of you may already know this information, but just bear with me. I'm just doing this in the simplest form just to expose what has already been in front of our faces, exposing. But now that that veil is lifted, I'm just lifting it, showing it in a different light, okay? Because all this information is easily found at your research and so it's nothing that you can't research on your own. It's nothing that, you know, But you do have to know what you're looking for to look for specific things. So that's why I'm doing this video. Now, we know that JC loves the number 7, okay? In Masonry and Illuminati, it means a light. And the light means Lucifer. So that's why you see him with the number 7. That's why he makes a lot of reference to the number 7. And also, I want to say this. If you hear anybody say protect your light or love and light, they're telling you to worship Lucifer. Okay? Because the light is Lucifer, and that's what they light. So that's what reference to. So you're being tricked by them to worship Luciferianism, as we all are. My last video, I made a joke about we're living in a world that is making people do crazy things, like putting dog feces in, with a contaminated mask and putting it back on your face. Yeah, that's it's crazy and it's funny when you look at it, but here's the seriousness of it, okay? Right now, all of our energies are being mixed with confusion, emotions, and chaos. We're all battling consciousness, and what it is that the elites or the powers that made baby, they need our energy, and they've always needed our energy, and they have to have that to gain their power and to maintain power. And right now, us awakened people, we are starting to connect our own conscious at our own conscious level. And I don't know if you notice it, we as individuals that are awakened, we're accepting the other ones, the other awakened ones. So we're aware and we're being brought together by this positive energy, which, you know, and the irony is being brought together by negative energy, because this veil has been lifted, okay? The telepathy powers is the powers that we forgot or has been suppressed that we have. And telepathy is, you know, it's on along the line of that's how we are on the same receptor, okay? Like, I could read your mind, I could read your thoughts, we're in the same place at the same time, you know, just, you get the word coincidence for that. So anyways, I want to say this, and then I'm going to, like I said, I'm going to play a few clips. I'm probably going to just let it play, and go from there. But I want to explain this. There are 3 different types of people, in this world. Number 1, they're spiritualists. They're the ones who cannot be swayed and will not be projected by any mainstream media. Number 2 is the intellectual one. They have mastered spirituality and understand creation. And number 3 is the sleepwalker. These people cannot discern spirituality from intellect. So they stay following mainstream media and worshiping their Hollywood idols. And many once it may have been a sleepwalker, now have been woken and now are aware of the deep dark secrets of the Illuminati and how Masons are definitely connected to Luciferian worship. This one of the first clips I'm going to play is gonna be, and I know this is old, but it's from a podcast, and I do believe it was in 2016. I may be wrong on the date. It may be 2016 or 17, but it was with Jamal Simmons, and he is the nephew of Russell Simmons. He also goes by the name Red Rum, and he's from the rap group Flatliners. He basically exposes what goes on in their meetings and rituals and what they have to do when they sign their soul. It's just a simple explanation. So, like I said, I'm just going to let these clips play, and I may do some editing throughout the rest of the video. But if not, I will be back with my next video and talk even more about the Masons. and finish out the series. And like always, I say thanks, stay safe and stay strong. And thank you for watching.
Being around Def Jam, y'all have been around the biggest of the big in the industry. Have you guys ever seen any weird, crazy shit go on? Any type of
realistic
shit?
Yep.
Wow.
Oh, man. Yeah, we
got to get too crazy about crazy, but like I said, I ain't seeking to go over there. Every little nigga out here I see run around and want to be a part of the industry, I just tell them, man, good luck, boy. Good luck. Every little girl that want to run around here and be a model and be on the good luck. You know what I mean? Because you're going to have to walk through them doors. Some doors I ain't wanting to walk through, dude. I'm not giving my soul up, and I'm not giving my whole up. I'm good. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Those two things, no soul in the hole, kid. You're not going to get...
and that's what they're coming after. That's what they want.
That's it, because they link. You got to understand, nigga. You know what I'm saying? No disrespect to the listeners, but your asshole is connected to your spine. It's connected to your brain. You know what I mean? And the message gets sent from one end directly up to the other, and shit happens. You know what I mean?
Right. No doubt.
You be one of those niggas out here liking it. After a while, at first you ain't want to deal with it, but now you liking it. You know what I mean? Out here dancing for baby, be out here dancing for baby, nigga, with nail polish on.
Right.
Talk about.
Russell, I mean, I might see someone like JayZ endorsing something like that, but I want to see Russell.
Can't do nothing, can't even get me hard. Like, what the fuck are you talking about, nigga?
What do you mean
the best can't get you hard?
What did you say, bro?
No, I said you'd be out here like...
No, not you.
Oh, no, I'm sorry.
No, I was just going to say, I would never picture anything like that coming from Russell Simmons. Surely he wouldn't be involved in that, would he?
Man, listen, like I said, man, everybody got a good side, an evil side, and I ain't going to say nothing more. All I'm saying, for any person with eyes, it's right there for you to see. That's all I'm going to say. I ain't going to say no more. He's my uncle, so I love him on that level. On other levels, we could talk, but not right now. You know what I mean? Everybody is good, have good parts of them and disagreeable parts of them. And nobody is going to get to be up there without going through a lot of shit. A lot of shit. You know what I'm saying? Of which I'm not willing to go through. No disrespect to people who go through that.
Shout out to Kwame.
To who?
What about Jay-Z? He rose to the top. How did he get there?
I'm saying he got there because he got there. Like I said, my dude, you know what I'm saying? You asking for answers that we could expound on, but you know what I mean? Shit's dangerous, nigga. You know what I'm saying?
So
what I'm going to say is that any motherfucker with eyes can see. It's very, very clear because they want it to be clear because they want you to know. So you can make a fucking informed decision. I know niggas worse of saying, but I'm still going to listen to them. That means you accept it. It was an informed, conscious, willing acceptance.
They let you know from the jump. That way you know exactly.
They want you to know. If they didn't want you to know, they control all media and all outlets of everything. It's Lucifer. And directly under him. You know what I mean? They control that. Any form of anything that you see that come to your eyes or come to your ears, they own it. And if it ain't in accordance with what they rocking with, they're going to eliminate you or cut you off. That's it.
Yeah,
you've seen it a million fucking times. And we keep talking about the same shit over and over again. We know what it is. We all know what it is.
Up to that, I wasn't aware of.
I don't know. I don't know where it came from. I don't know where it started, but...
People are really buying into this that you are some sort of Freemason something.
Man,
what are you up to that I wasn't aware of?
I don't know. I don't know where it came from. I don't know where it started, but you know.
Well, there's all these images and videos that people are saying are deliberate. My question to you is, are you messing with people and doing this on purpose?
No, not me. No, never done that before. Why would I do that? That's retarded. To be honest with you, I really think it's really silly, you know. For the record, you know, I of course believe in God, but I believe in one God. you know, if people must know my religious beliefs, I believe in one God. I don't believe in religion. I don't believe in Christians or Muslims. I think all that separates people. I think it's one God. I think it's all the same God, and I don't believe in hell. Hmm. But as far as God, of course I believe in God. And am I a part of some type of sect or cult? That sounds stupid to me. It's like ignorant to even say. And I guess that'll be the last time I address that. But, you know, it's really...
Aren't there little secret societies?
Yeah, right here. It's the mob squad. Nation is a gang. I mean, but as far as, you know, I can't even get in a golf club in Palm Springs. I'm from Marcy Projects. Imagine... They just think about that, like...
They wouldn't let you in the club, you saying?
Of course not. How? People that control the world and, you know...
Do you believe that those sort of organizations exist?
I think there's friends. I think there's cliques of friends who control things. I don't know if it's a devil worshiping sect. I think that's a little Tom Hanks.
Right.
but I believe there's cliques of people that control the world. Like, if, you know, Jeezy's my man. I got Atlanta. I go down Atlanta. I got that thing. You know, I know he come down Brooklyn. He got that thing. I go down Virginia. But, you know, that's just natural process. You know, I'm sure Obama has his people that, you know, everything is good.
That he rocks with.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but, you know, as far as, you know,